team, we made our way to Kobaridi, which is at the beginning of the Soca Valley. We knew it would be a beautiful place just by the sights on the way. Sochi to Kobaridi, passing through Tolmi. It's a bit wild, but well worthy.
The next 2 days. We are in the village of Kobarit and Camp Korem partner up with us, and we are staying in this amazing bungalow. Seriously, we couldn't be happier because it's definitely the most comfortable and cozy accommodation we got so far, right?
Absolutely, this place is great.
Now we are waiting for the game as well to start, because in 20 minutes it should start the Champions League, Liverpool against Maribor. And as we already said, we met the captain of Maribor team, which is the Brazilian, Marcos Tavares.
Go Maribor!
Woohoo! So we're gonna be supporting Maribor while cooking in our awesome chalet. It's a shame you cannot see outside because there is the Soca River just coming in front of our door. But you will see everything tomorrow because we're gonna go outside again, put the drone up, put the camera, and introduce you guys to this amazing place.
waterfall. It's amazing. You can stay here all day. This is near Kobarid. You need to take a trekking up 20 minutes, not too far, and walk and you see a beautiful landscape. And this is the end. Breathtaking.
It's our first day in Kobarid, and we are already loving it. Like, the place we are staying is amazing. This cozy chalet just 20 minutes away from here. And there's just so much nature around, and this is the first thing we are seeing, and look at that!
Seriously, can you stay all day?
So after exploring a little bit of Kobarid today and getting to know these waterfalls and river, we are now enjoying ourselves in this luxury bungalow. While T cooks for me, for us, come on. What are you cooking, T?
Some potatoes with tomato sauce and a salad for entrance. Baridi, a beautiful place, and we will explore Tolmin, a bit of the region, see more of nature, and sad that it's coming to an end, but there's still things to say.
So after cycling for around 30 minutes, we arrived here at the Tolmin Gorges, and we are excited for what we're gonna see. We're gonna show you everything. Apparently there are some caves and some waterfalls and the rivers, this point where the rivers meet, so it's very beautiful. This is the first impression we are having inside the national park, and we already like it so much.
So, in this edge of the gorge, we find the natural spring right over there. So basically, the water underneath the earth is heated by geothermal energy, and then they resurface, they come up from natural fences of the rock, and then they come up from right over there. Natural springs are not uncommon. You see many of them in Slovenia. However, they're not very common. They're a bit rare in the Julian Alps in this region. So this is quite something in here. And also, a rock just fell over there, which made the level of the rise rise the level of the river. And then you don't really often see the water coming from the spring. But because today the level is low, you can see the water come from there, which is nice. So we are in this cave, which is part of the gorge on the passage that you go around, And this cave is interesting. First, because you cannot go in, because it's very dark, so you need a professional equipment. We need a guide. And secondly, because apparently the patriarch, back in the day, the patriarch of this area was an Italian guy, something della Torre. He invited Dante Alighieri.
Yeah, he hosted him in this area.
In Tolmin. And then he brought Dante Alighieri to this cave. And they said that this cave inspired Dante to create the hell of his famous comedy, the Divine Comedy.
Yeah, and actually he was already writing it, right? And then he was here and inspired him. So that's how the cave is called. So, Dante Alighieri.
Yeah, exactly. So they nicknamed Dante Alighieri Cave. We called it a day and went back to Camp Coreng to get ready for our departure early next morning. Breda, the Slovenian Tuscany.